And now Rafael will teach you A3 management.
Hey, this lecture will be about the famous A3. We'll talk about what it is, we'll discuss why it is so widely used by companies, and then we'll have a closer look about the single pieces of it. So let's jump into it. The A3 or A3 report is a structured problem-solving tool developed by Toyota. It was used to communicate and to report improvement measures. Why is it called A3? Well, that's pretty simple. It's because of the size of the paper. Most of you write on DIN A4 paper, but A3, as the name says, was that everything that is supposed to be told by the improvement measure should fit on one piece of paper, one A3 paper. Besides problem solving, companies use the A3 report for different purposes, for instance, for meeting minutes or for project proposals. What is special about the A3 is that it does not limit the creativity to stick to text, but it encourages the users to fill in graphics, illustrations, or other data that is relevant for the problem. This brings us to the question why it is so widely used in industry. First of all, it's simple. This simplicity is very useful to be applied on a daily basis. Second, it's logical structure. It follows the PDCA cycle that Deming was developing. PDCA stands for Plan, Do, Check, Act. Even though the A3 encourages a storytelling approach along the PDCA cycle, it does not limit itself to qualitative data. It encourages the user instead to also gather as much quantitative data as possible. The goal is to understand the real cause, the root cause of the problem first, before somebody tries to come up with a solution. This prevents that the team that tries to solve the problem is so-called jumping to conclusions, so taking a conclusion before the problem is fully understood. This phenomenon happens all too often in industry, where we are very quick in coming up with solutions, but we tend to forget if we really understood the problem. Through this notion of understanding the root cause first, before we come up with a solution, the A3 helps to train employees in scientific thinking and thereby creates thinking problem solvers in your company.
Let's take a look at the A3 template. Even though there are multiple variants of the layout, the 7 sections you see here are the typical sections of an A3. The header indicates a specific title and a responsible person for the A3. The first step describes what we are looking at. What is the process we are concerned with? Step 2 grasps the current situation of this process. A good A3 is precise in specifying the current situation. Including numbers and figures can facilitate this. Similarly, in the target setting, a specific target is inserted. Also here, numbers and figures about the future process can help. The following 4th step reveals the root cause of the deviation between the current and the target situation. It uses analytical approaches such as the fishbone diagram to understand what is causing the problem. Only when the problem is fully understood, the development of the countermeasures in step 5 is performed. Creative solutions to these problems are developed and compared in this step. Step 6 then executes the solution that is chosen and analyzes whether the problem is solved by that. Finally, the last step recaps what we learned from going through the problem-solving cycle of the A3. This step is crucial to manifest the knowledge that is gained from this process. Looking closer, these 7 steps show that the A3 is aligned with the PDCA. The first 4 sections correspond to the plan phase of the PDCA. The development of countermeasure is connected with the do phase, and as the name implies, step 6, execute and check results, corresponds to the check phase. Finally, follow-up and lessons learned resembles the act phase. Hence, the A3 emphasizes and ensures the logic of the PDCA cycle is followed.
This little example should have showed you the concept and the benefits of A3. However, it's not a one-fits-all solution. There are some particular situations in which an A3 report is better suited and some situation in which it is not. First of all, when the problem is very simple at hand, then go and just solve it. Don't try to come up with an A3 report that is mainly used for reporting what you have done and nobody will really read it. If the problem, however, is a bit more complex and requires you to think through and think about the root cause, then it's definitely time to use an A3. Further, if there is the personal development possible through the A3 so that the employee learns through that problem solving, it's definitely worthwhile to engage in an A3 because, again, thereby we create scientific problem solvers. Finally, if the knowledge that we obtain from undergoing an A3 and undergoing a problem solving cycle is valuable in the future, for instance, if the problem could reoccur in some other departments or some other areas, it's definitely useful to use an A3 because the knowledge sharing about how we solve the problem is very easy and can be facilitated by looking and reading the A3. Even though it has a lot of potentials, there are common misconceptions about the A3. In following, I'll just go about the most common mistakes in using an A3. Mistake number one, form over content. An A3 is not a beauty contest. Of course, as we said before, images and graphs can support the problem solving and readability of an A3. However, you don't need to make the graphs look nice and make it everything in beautiful colors and whatnot. Make it simple, make it readable and transparent, but it doesn't need to win a beauty contest. The second most common mistake is to squeeze text into boxes. People get very creative in putting as much content as possible in the boxes of an A3. But just because you have a talent of writing very tiny letters, it doesn't mean that you should. Don't put too much content into the boxes. There is a reason why an A3 is printed on an A3 paper, and it should be remained readable from a fair distance. So try to put only as much content into the A3 as is necessary to understand the problem. The third most common mistake, doing it all alone. The A3 encourages you to work together. The form and the content that you put in there, it's all meant to be discussed with each other in a team or in several units. So when you do have A3, make sure that you do it together with somebody or at least make it reviewed by somebody else. I hope by giving you these three common mistakes on applying A3, we prevent you from doing the very same mistakes as well. Now it's time for you to go out there and apply the A3 in your professional or in your personal life. Maybe you have this dirty kitchen in your shared apartment that you want to improve. It's time for you to use the A3 to solve that. And on that journey to become a scientific problem solver, I wish you good luck and welcome you in the next lecture.